Focus on the fundamentals, one game at a time. If you put your effort and concentration into playing to your potential, there's no one would live with this team. Today is not about the past. It's not about the future. It's about right now. And you've got to want that. You've got to want that like you're fighting for your last breath in this life. One life. You're here because you said, I believe in this team and we will finish what we started. When there's one need. You have within you an incredible strength that comes from being part of something truly special. Knowing that even in your darkest hour, no matter how futile or impossible the road may seem, you are never alone on this team. 80,000 people are saying, we believe in you. Will you stand up and fight for us? We get to share it. They will learn that if they knock you down, another will take your place. And if they knock him down, we'll just come back at them harder. And if they knock you down again, they're going to know what it's like to have 80,000 people come crashing down on them like their worst nightmare, because we carry each other. The only thing that's certain in this life is that the clock is constantly running until you can't outrun it anymore and you're finally called back in. That's when you take stock and you know in your heart if you're a winner. It's not about medals. It's about the times you were there for your teammates. The times they needed you and you were there. And they need you today. And we need you right now. One team. One blood. Today is about immortality, because no matter what happens out there today, even if victory seems impossible, we know that you will never give up on us, because we will never give up on you. Look up, get up, stand up and fight. Brothers, sisters, one life, one love, one team.
We are.
We are.
We are. We are the Cathedral Fighting Irish.
up in lights. He just wants to be heard, whether it's the beat of the mic. He feels so unlike everybody else, alone, in spite of the fact that some people still think that they know. But no, he knows the code. It's not about the salary, it's all about reality and making some noise, making a story, making sure his click stays up. That means when he puts it down, talks picking it up. Let's go.
Who the hell is he anyway? He never really talks much, never concerned with status, but still even in starstruck. Humble through opportunities given despite the fact that many misjudge him because he makes a living from writing raps. Put it together himself, got a picture connects. Never asking for someone's help or to get some respect. He's only focused on what he wrote. His will is beyond reach, and now it all unfolds. The skill of an artist.
This is 20% skill, 80% gear. Be 100% clear, cause Ryu was ill. Who would have thought he'd be the one that set the West in flames? Then I heard him wreck it with the crystal method, name of the game. Came back, dropped Megadeth, took him to church. I like Bleach, man. Ryu had the stupidest verse. This dude is the truth. Now everybody giving them guest spots and stocks through the roof. I heard him f***ing with that stock.
This is 10% luck, 20% skill, 15% concentrated power of will, 5% pleasure, 50% pain, and 100% reason to remember the name.
He's sick and he's spitting fire and Mike. Got him out the dryer, he's hot. Found him in Fort Minor with top. What a f***ing nihilist porcupine. He's a the type women wanna be within rappers. Hope he gets 8 years in the making, patiently waiting to blow. Now the record with Shinoda's taking over the globe. He's got a partner in crime. This is equally dope. You won't believe the kind of that comes out of this kid's throat.
He's not your everyday on the block. He knows how to work with what he's got, making his way to the top. He often gets a comment on his name. People keep asking him, was it given that birthday doesn't stand for an acronym? No, he's living proof. Put a rock in the booth. He'll get you. Wasn't cool.
And down deep in the corner, so you can get trapped there where Hartman just shot the ball. And Hartman hits his 29th three of the season.
He writes every line, and I've seen him at work. When that light goes on in his mind, it's like a design is written in his head. Every time
he touches a key or speaks in a rhyme, he knows all the fellas he runs with. He's in his head. Now he's trying how to do it. He's screaming for 5 seconds. But look who bought it, they're at home. She says, look what I found in box number 50 is stolen. Nice pass by Hartman. Inside Dixon. And he scores. A terrific play by the Irish. Walking around, he didn't go through warm-up. I don't think we're going to see great miles. Hartman with a follow-away spin move. You can't defense that.
Remember who your friends are. Starts with your family. Okay? And then the friends are those guys that you bleed with, that you sweat with, that you eat with, that you practice with. Those are your guys. Remember that.
Picture success. Believe it will come to you. You got what you deserve.
Credit Union, the end of the week on TV 40.
playing with tough men that have to rise in tough circumstances to play this game the way it's meant to be played. And that's the way it's always been played here.
Cathedral and the Red Devils of Pike High School coming offensively in steals, and offensively is the top assist man. Pull-up jumper right out front, good. 54 and a half. Well, they shot the ball well today, 49%. They shoot 50% on the year. First couple of points in the ball game. And the three, got it again. They shot the ball, as I mentioned, so good today.
In. This is a start that favors Cathedral. Pike is not getting out to that blistering start.
Oh, nice looking baseline shot on the left side. He had a hand to reduce it 11-9. Baseline, put up jumper, Coleman. By Patterson and stolen away. Another turnover by Pike. They've got numbers on the break. They got the layup. Turned on the 9th of January in a game at Carmel and returned with 16 points. And here is Gregory.
5 for 13, Jerry.
They use the high pick, and they get the ball inside. They get the bucket and draw the foul. Nice looking game. Open look, right side, Coleman.
And he emphasized that enough.
Well, they get the layup inside. 15-footer, right side, yeah.
Now
nice looking play.
Absolutely.
Boy, I tell you, you talk about a shot under pressure at all, and they relied on that. They were 4 of 11 in the first half.
Yeah, and it wasn't so much the percentage, although not real great.
And that was at 2-0. Wide open look for the three by Hartman. He got it.
Yeah, but the difference. Well, Pike makes a great opportunity there, Jerry.
Rebound, and the pull-up shot will fall. Time by Turner.
Oh, great pass.
And a breakaway now. Here is Sullen.
Absolutely super pass by Dixon for the flush.
He won 39. That, believe it or not, equals the biggest lead that Pike's had in this game. Oh, a nice entry pass down inside to Barthel.
Yep. This is a big possession for Cathedral.
And they got it inside. Nice work by Jalen Coleman.
All over a lot.
Long range three.
Got it.
Oh, what a play by Coleman.
That's big.
Ties the ball game at 46.
It's miss one, you're in trouble.
Even though we just started the fourth quarter, you get that sense that any kind of a mistake. Yeah, that's a shot just inside the 3-point zone by Coleman again. Boy, this young man is living up to it. The shot that is missed by Hartman. No foul, but they get the ball back at the layup. Inside, that's where they want to go. to Hartman. Now they go back outside to Dixon again.
That's great offense. That's for 46. Cathedral 22 for 46. That's pretty close, too.
Doesn't get much better than that. Scooping shot. Coleman. Shot would not fall. And look who's got the rebound again, Colin Hartman.
Pike needs a stop.
Quickly up court. Somebody forgot about Dixon. He got inside and got the bucket.
Pike needs a T.O.
Dixon now with six. And I believe we're going to get a full timeout taken by Pike. Now they double out high. Hard to the hoop is Coleman.
Oh, my goodness. That's a money shot.
Basketball has that job. And the Pink Red Devils throw it away.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, wow. Pike with just a huge turnover now.
No good. And
that's a
ball game. What a game.
Boy, wasn't it, though. Both teams so well coached. It could have went either way. It just, boy, a huge, huge turnover for Pike. Just took it away from him.
What a ball game, big guy.
Boy, I'm here to tell you, Jerry, it was just excellent, excellent high school basketball. You couldn't ask for anything more. We talked about all stars on both teams, big time plays.
I've had my shots and kicks in my face, but I come through.
I need to go home.
Practice on Monday.
Come on, Andy. You just beat a big time play. You're thinking about practice? Come on, baby.
Bodyworks, the collision experts. Now, Renner Nixon. Bodyworks, same great people, same great service.
And everything that goes.
To serve you better.
Thank you
all. Over 40 years experience, Renner Nixon Bodyworks collision repair. Number one in quality. Final score again.
No pleasure. Indianapolis
Cathedral 62.
I consider it a challenge before the whole human race.
Come on.
IHSAA Champions Television Network. Welcome to the coverage of the 103rd Annual IHSAA Boys State Finals presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance. Game number 4 on a full day of fun here at Bankers Life Fieldhouse in downtown Indianapolis. Next up, the 4A Championship game, the Carmel Greyhounds and the Irish of Cathedral. They had to beat number 9, Lawrence North, number 10, Indianapolis Tech in the Warren Central Sectional, then number 5, Pike in the Southport Regional. Then last week, they went to Seymour, Indiana, down South, beat 13th-ranked Jeffersonville.
Number 20, Josh Sullivan. Number 30, Mac Gregory. Number 32, Sherrod Thomas. Number 34, Omari Robinson. Number 40, Devin Dixon. And the starting lineup for the Fighting Irish. At guard, a 6'3" sophomore, number 5, Jalen Coleman. At guard, a 6'2" senior, number 23, Garrett Hall. At guard, a 5'7" freshman, number 24, Tiernan Cook. At forward, a 6'7" junior, number 2, Colin Barfell. At forward, a 6'6" senior, number 33, Colin Hartman. The head coach of the 25-5 Fighting Irish, Andy Vega.
He's the Big Ol' Irish head coach, Andy Fagan, third year at the school, a record of 62-13.
There's a sub story tonight.
Yeah, that's nice. Of course, Scott's not real pleased about that right now. I'm joking. They're good buddies.
I'm not sure he really is thinking too much about that one.
We have the second quarter off the iron in 23-8. Down the lane. Got it.
Run with it, but there's just not been enough missed shots for me to get that done.
Shot.
All the other shots he's had, he's in.
Fourth quarter coming up, 39-28. Carmel over Cathedral on the IHSAA Champions Network. Wide open look, about 15 feet out, he's good. Colin Barthel now with 8 points in the moment. They're showing the first aerial of 3 by Coleman. Coleman again. He's starting to come to life.
That's a big basket for Farmer right there.
2:05 to play. Pull up jumper. Got it. Good looking shot by Garrett Hall. All of them out of the day there by Barthel. Now the shot in the corner on air ball. And picked back up and put back up underneath. And I wonder just what Steve and I were talking about a couple of moments ago. Long range three. Got it again. That's Garrett Hall from outside. Left side, Colin Hartman.
How do I
Hard to say goodbye to yesterday.